A number of the exercises in this online course use asset-based PI system references. And you might be asking, well, what if I don't have an asset database? Well, never fear, we actually have an answer for you. So in this short video, I'm going to show you how to take an XML file that we provide and how to import it into the PI system really easily so that you can use all the same examples within AF that we're using. Now, it's going to use some random based tags that are on your PI system and every PI system, so some of the data might not make contextual sense, but it will be coming through as numbers. And I'm going to show you in this video how to take that XML file with an example PI asset database and put it into the PI system. Okay, so let's get started. All right, now the first step in importing a new AF database is to get that AF database in a XML format. So your instructor can provide this for you, or we might have provided it through download, but I have it here in my Windows Explorer here. I can see I have this folder and I have these three XMLs. Now I'm going to be importing these four XMLs. I'm going to be importing these XMLs files, but you may have just one, you might have more than this, depending on what the course is. What this is it's a file in XML format that includes all the information needed for the PI system to construct a new asset database. All right, so let's get started. So we have those files, and we're going to open up PI System Explorer. Now this is kind of an administrative program that's meant to explore a PI server and administer a PI system. And in it, we can see asset databases, we can see data, but it's mostly meant to build or construct asset databases. If you don't have access to this software, that's okay. You should go talk to your PI administrator. Or if you don't have access to build anything, you should probably talk to your PI administrator. So first off, I'm in a blank database. And you can select database and find a database in your list here. So I've created, and you can do whatever you want here, but I've created just a blank database for what I'll be doing for this class. So it's just a bunch of example databases. Now once I have this, there's nothing in it, I am going to want to import these files. And the way I do that is I go to File, Import from File, and I'm going to go browse to where those files are, and I can select one, so let's say New Green. And I'll say open. And I wanted to say allow create, update, automatic check-in. And I am not going to be creating any points, so you can leave this unchecked. Press OK. And you'll see a bunch of text flash in the screen. And once it completes, you'll select close. Once you've imported the database, you'll see an asset show up here. So this is New Green. This just represents a company. And underneath it, we see different assets, different divisions within the company, finally all the way down to equipment. This is a boiler. Here, this is a cooling fan. And if we click on attributes, we can see attributes about that fan. And if you click on different assets, you'll see different sets of attributes. And one thing, if you go to one of these yellow tag-based attributes, you should see numbers. And if you go over here, you should see your default PI server. So this XML is configured so that it will go find whatever default PI server you have and enter it there. If you don't know what your default PI server is, you can check it by going to File, Connections, and it will be whichever blue PI server has a check mark next to it. So you see that little check mark next to pipes there? I'll zoom in so you can see it. The check mark next to pipes, that means that's the default. If I wanted to set a different one as default, I could just right-click and set as a default PI server. Okay, so this one looks like it successfully came in. I'll also notice if I go to Library, there's a set of tables. And there might also be some element templates that came in as well. Okay, so everything looks good. I'm going to import the other XML files. So File, Import from File. And select Office HVAC. Close. And I can see this one has come through okay. File, Import from File, Red Fox Reactor. File, Import from File, OSIsoft wind turbines, okay. And finally, we should be able to open up any of these and see data underneath them. Now, all of the data in all of the assets you imported will just be going off of the random tags that are installed on every Pi server. So the data will be a little, well, it will be the same. It'll be the same tags and the same data that's feeding all these attributes, but there'll be some variety. We've randomized which tags are going to which assets and which attributes, and they should all be going off your default Pi server. Okay, that's importing an XML to form an AF database. Pretty simple. Good luck and enjoy the exercises with them. Play around. Once you have these in here, play around. Do whatever you want. You can edit the templates, you can edit the at elements. If you break it, you can just delete it and re-import it again. There's no problem. Go ahead and try things.